folks. I'm here in San Francisco, California at Neomodern. This is a place that was put together by my good friend, Mr. Michael Rubin. We're going to go in and see what it's all about. Let's go.
This is TWiP.
So Michael Rubin, welcome to your facility.
Great to see you. I can't believe it's been forever.
It's been forever. We were talking about before off camera. It's been a couple of decades.
Yeah, it's hard to imagine when we're so young.
I know.
Anything happened a couple.
It's like I'm negative now because.
Like when Mozart was my age, he'd been dead for 10 years. You know.
There you go. What was that movie? Benjamin Buttons.
Right? Yes, I'm Benjamin Buttons.
Yeah, because you were much older last time I saw you.
Totally true. Okay.
All right. So this place.
I think of it like a temple of photography.
Yeah.
It's kind of, for people who love photography, it's really a special space. The business of Neomodern is pretty straightforward. It's like people walk down the street in San Francisco. This is Union Street, a super popular, cool.
This is like hipster central
It's a nice place. I think of it kind of like yoga street. There's kind of yoga all over. Anyway, they walk in with their phones. Our staff are all fine art printers. Mm-hmm. So these are experts at not just photography, but they work with artists all the time and print that work for museums and galleries and collectors.
Yeah.
So these are the best printers money can buy.
Sure.
And they are available to the public. So people walk into Neomodern and sit down in this kind of cozy central area we call the nest,
mm-hmm.
and we work with you on your pictures. We make those pictures look great using Lightroom and Photoshop and just being good photographers.
Yeah.
And when you like it, when it's right, we print it out archivally,
mm-hmm.
so it's gonna last. We custom cut a mat mm-hmm. on this kind of cool machine.
It's a robot.
Yeah. And then we custom frame it and you're done in 30 minutes. So people walk in with their phones and they walk out with like a framed work of art, and it's enormously gratifying.
That's crazy. We're going to talk about that, just kind of the benefits of moving out of the digital realm or the Instagram realm and into the physical atom-based world. I love the atom-based
instead
world.
Instead of the electron world, you got the
electrons
atom.
To atoms.
You know, I don't
photons to electrons to atoms.
I don't like to feel like we're a retro thing, even though we really are into photography. Too often when people think that, they think you're into film and mm-hmm. silver printing and celluloid and chemicals and all that. And the truth is, no one cares how you shoot the picture.
Sure.
I don't know if you had a pinhole camera or you've got a big giant box camera or even digital.
Mm-hmm.
The truth is, taking a photograph is taking a photograph. But printing is something else.
Yeah.
Making a physical object out of your print and deciding how people will experience that
mm-hmm.
is non-trivial. That is photography. I would actually go so far as to say, if you don't do that work, you're not really a photographer.
Yeah.
Man, that's fighting words, I know.
Those are fighting words. Neomodern.com is they have a comment area. But yeah, I mean, I would put a different spin on that.
Please.
So I would say, yes, printing is a possible outcome mm-hmm. in a world of infinite outcomes, right?
Yes.
Infinite universes, multiverse. but printing, the physical print, is a possible outcome, but it's a fork in the evolutionary tree of photography, I think. One of the forks is Instagram. Another fork is printing. Maybe another fork is, doing these cinemagraph type things.
Okay. I mean, I hear that, and it's true. I mean, if you take pictures and you post them on Instagram, there is it's really gratifying to get those likes and whatever.
But instant endorphin.
And that's cool, and it takes art, it takes skill to take pictures that people like. But it is the product that you're making, the thing that you're making, is being consumed in a way that you don't control.
Yeah.
They're looking at it quickly, they're looking at it small, you've got this unbelievable camera, and most importantly, you're not really selecting what is the one picture that's iconic for this set of pictures you took.
Sure.
Now, maybe some people use Instagram that way, but I would suggest that the task of going through the 1,000 pictures you took on vacation and picking out the 2 or 5 that are actually great, mm-hmm. that really kind of sum up this vacation for you beautifully, mm-hmm. and making them physical. So you've decided how someone will look at, how far you stand from it, how big is it going to be, what exactly does it look like.
Mm-hmm.
That is part of photography. It's not, photography isn't just pushing the button on a camera, which is largely automated today. Mm-hmm. It is doing the hard work to make the decision about what you're going to see and how you're going to see it. And if I don't do that, I would say you're not really a photographer.
And I think to kind of like squeeze the nugget out of that, or the lemon juice of it, it's, I don't know where these analogies
the
are coming
juice?
From.
Where the hell did you get lemon juice?
No idea where that came from.
We're shooting.
Oh, good. Yeah.
And we're drinking, yeah.
Full service at Neomodern.
This place is great.
I love this place. Thank you. But the idea of spending time and investing your time and effort, which is a finite resource, right?
Right, right.
Investing your valuable time and effort into something like a print, or like we didn't even talk about one of your other companies that you started a while back called Petroglyph, mm-hmm. where people are physically going into a space similar to this and working with clay and other materials and creating something that they are putting their time into, and then they get a physical object out. That object is imbued with that time That's and true. The memories that it took to put it together.
That's a good point. That's right? a good point. It is nice to know when you give a photograph, it's more than you just took a picture and here's a copy of the picture.
Yeah.
It's like, it is a craft project. I'm making this thing for you. It's like a handmade card.
Sure.
It's a handmade object that I'm doing nicely for you. And you're right. Neomodern is participatory in the same way that Petroglyph mm-hmm. and Glow and some of these other businesses are participatory. You don't just, it's not an errand. This is something you come and do.
Yeah.
And you took the picture and now you make a cool print out of it.
Yeah.
And that's something important to us.
Yeah. I don't know if your marketing department has thought about this, but I would like, and we mentioned this off camera, I would like a subscription to this place.
Interesting.
Where I can come in and print. I would also like to be able to gift these to photographers that I know.
Well, you can get gift certificates.
Oh, you can.
You can
okay.
online. You can get a gift card, and it is a great thing for a photographer to have.
Yeah. What a great prize, too. Oh,
it's nice. And yeah. it is so fun to see your print. I mean, as a photographer, it's so nice to see your print on a wall. Those are
sure.
mine.
Yeah, you know. Beautiful.
It's
yeah.
cool, right? And it's different. If you looked at that on an iPhone, you might be like, whatever.
Mm-hmm.
But when you see it and you make it, it's making a statement in a
yeah.
sense.
Mm-hmm.
So you're freeing it.
You're freeing it from the camera roll, right?
Yeah.
So talk to me about the flow. So we didn't talk about the flow of somebody, they're walking, you know, tourists are walking around here all the time.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, look at this place. Let's go look at that. They may come in because they may initially think it's a gallery.
They
right?
do think it's a gallery. We actually have a sign in front that says, mm-hmm. this is not a gallery.
This is not a gallery.
Which is kind of a joke because it's totally a gallery.
Yeah.
But
no one reads anyway.
Yeah, you know, a gallery to me is a place that's in the business of selling the pictures on the wall. And that's not really our primary business. We sell customers' works, actually.
Okay.
If a customer comes through here and does something really amazing, we will, if they agree to it, we will print and frame that at our cost, hang it next to the Ansel Adams or the Cartier-Bresson, and offer it for sale. And people do buy that stuff. We don't sell the Cartier-Bressons and the Cartesians. I don't think people can afford them,
yeah.
but it's not really our business. That yeah. they're here for kind of inspiration and education.
Yeah, yeah. So someone walks in off the street.
They walk in off the street.
What happens?
They come in. I got to say, a lot of times people don't know what they want to print.
Yeah.
And you think that you need to kind of get prepared before you come here. Mm-hmm. But you don't. You walk in off the street, and this happens every day. They sit in the nest, and we go through 1,000 pictures of their vacation or their wedding.
Wow.
I've seen more dog pictures than I care to shake
I
a
bet.
Stick at. Yeah.
I bet.
And they're the question
and they're
is
all
like,
the best.
And they're adorable. they're totally adorable. So we're going through, and we put them up on a big screen, and we look through them and help people pick out what pictures, in our estimation, really are going to stand the test of time.
Sure.
You know, I mean, there's a ton of great pictures here, but what is better than, like, aren't you good? Because people will get bored with pictures. You
yeah,
know, they
yeah.
they have a kind of an immediate hit, kind of the Instagram hit of, like, that's pretty,
mm-hmm.
but it doesn't have more to it, and it gets boring.
Yeah.
You know how, like, on record albums, you remember record albums?
No.
They were like these things. There would be songs between other songs.
I saw them in a museum once.
Yeah. I'll tell you about it sometime. They're really cool. But there'd be songs that were in between the hit songs. And, you know, in a hit-driven world, you wouldn't listen to it. But after you listen to the album a bunch,
yeah.
you start to like those kind of hidden ones more. And mm-hmm. the popular ones get kind of boring.
Right.
It's true for photography as well. Your immediate rush of, like, that's a cool picture, I love that, you know, might go away. And the picture that's a little more complicated, a little more interesting, is the one that is that you really want on your wall that you enjoy for years because it grows on you.
Right, right.
So we kind of give that advice to people. We help them with that if they want it. Some people don't. You know, they know exactly what they want.
Yeah, when
they
this one. In. Golden this Gate one. Bridge.
Golden Gate Bridge. Print it now. Yeah. Now, right. Yeah. And so that's what happens. They sit with us. We work on it. We print it out and custom cut the mat. It's also a nice moment. Many people sign their prints because they are photographic artists. And we have a signing station here with a ton of different pens and pencils.
Very cool.
And you sign your work. Oh, you know, I mentioned this earlier. Some parents come in here and they're printing a baby picture maybe of, of their newborn. And before we frame it, they write a little message to the baby.
That's so cool.
In the part of the under the mat, so no one will see it, and then it gets sealed into the frame, and it's archival, so that thing will be there for 100 years, and then like someday this kid opens up this picture, and there's a message like from their grandparents to their parents when their dad was a baby, and now they have this thing. So
Next civilization,
or the next.
What is this we found in the rubble that was San Francisco?
I love that. I mean, even on the museum pieces, sometimes I'll lift up in a mat, and it'll be like Merry Christmas 1912 from Grandpa to
Isn't
you.
That great?
I
that
love
great.
Those little messages.
And you can't do that with digital.
You can't do it with online.
Right.
And so I worry about that a little bit because there's so much about Neomodern which is about that participation and creation of this object.
Yeah. But is that a lost art, though, in a lot of ways? Because printing has been around forever. Fine art printing has been around since we've been able to do fine art printing.
Right.
But it feels like we're in this Instagram, I need it now, instant gratification. Almost like you mentioned, like it's almost like like the endorphin rush that you get from the likes and the thumbs up and all this ratings and all this stuff. It's an endorphin rush or a drug. Endorphin, you know, it's a drug that you get. And like any drug over time, it numbs you. So now great photography, something that would have been considered amazing 10 years ago is now like, oh, great, next.
Right.
Right?
Because you get so much of that.
Is that good? The bar is higher or is that bad? And then the question to you is, bridging the world from digital to physical, you as a putting on your marketing hat, you have to figure that how to get that into your customers' minds, right? Because you have a demographic that comes in here that has been marinating in Instagram for years.
But they're also the pendulum swings, right? Yeah. Like we're also noticing people are buying record albums and cassette tapes in ways that like I can't believe that's coming back because you know streaming is so convenient, and I think that that's true for photography as well. People, it's great that you can share on Instagram, but the creation of a physical object is special.
Yeah.
It is special. You know, I like to talk about a baseball. If someone showed me a baseball and it's like, oh, it's just a baseball. But, oh, this was the baseball that Babe Ruth hit out of the park in the World Series. Suddenly, even though it still looks like a baseball, it's a different baseball, right?
It's got memories in it. Yeah.
Photographs are objects. They have history. They are handled. They age a little bit, and they are objects that you can track around. And I think that photography is about creating the object, not just an image that has been snapped.
Right.
So I want to reconnect people to that. And I think young people are growing dissatisfied a little bit with the ephemeral nature of all media. I mean, it's nice to free. It's nicely freeing.
Yeah.
Because you don't have to carry all this junk around. But there also is a kind of a disconnect. And like sometimes it's nice to have a couple of nice things.
And you want to do something different, right? You want to do something different than the legions of your followers and friends are doing. Uh-oh. Oh, the robot's on.
The robot's
on. It's the robot back there. R2. Is that BB-8? Yeah. Have you given it a name yet?
No, we've not given
it a name. Come on. You are involved with the Lucas, and you haven't named your droid?
Well, the droid is sort of... Yeah, I'm not sure what's going on with the droid. It's a wizard.
It's
a wizard. Which is the brand, but we refer to it as the wizard.
Which could also be called a Jedi. I'm just saying.
Oh, yeah.
Just saying. All right. So sorry.
Okay. So we're talking about physical objects. You talk a little bit about the market for this kind of thing. And, you know, physical printing of photographs used to be the only way you experienced photographs for the most part, right?
Yeah.
And to make a print of this size, of this quality, you're shooting on film.
Yeah.
But in about 2000, 2001, film cameras started going away. As you know, they're being replaced by smartphones, digital cameras. And I think at the peak of film camera sales, there are about 40 million of those being sold a year. But last year, there was about 1.5 billion smartphones being sold.
Yeah.
So you had like all of these film cameras that could make prints, then they went away. Mm-hmm. And then you had them replaced by all these digital cameras. But the digital cameras took crappy pictures.
Yeah.
And it really wasn't until 2017 that the picture coming out of your smartphone was actually good enough to make a print like this. So you had a market go away, and now it, with a big hole, mm-hmm. and then suddenly I think you're seeing like, wow, everybody's got a camera that can make prints that are nice. And I'm trying to connect those people to photography. They all have something like a Leica in their pocket every day.
Every day, everywhere they go.
Everywhere they go, but they don't really know that much. They're not exposed to great photography.
Yeah.
And maybe they see some beautiful stuff on Instagram, but there's a history of photography. And I'd like to connect people to the history of modernist photography in particular, mm-hmm. because that came out of a time when cameras were being liberated.
Yeah.
Suddenly anyone could have a 35 millimeter camera and buy film. And in the mid-century, Paris in particular, street photographers were a big deal. Cartier-Bresson, Courtège, mm-hmm. Robert Doisneau, Elliot Erwitt. These guys walked around with their cameras and saw cool things in the world and took pictures, and their pictures are amazing.
Yeah.
And I think that's is the most instructive kind of photography to people today walking around with their smartphones.
Yeah.
So that's why we hang this modernist photography in the gallery, mm-hmm. and it's why we're called Neo-Modern. I think there'll be a kind of a renaissance of art photography from people, not sort of conceptual photography, not sort of museum-y, mm-hmm. but just great street photography. So my pictures from Thanksgiving are just a little, they're not just crappy snapshots, but they're like nicely done.
Yeah.
And that's, I hope, what people sort of take away.
That's interesting. Okay, so we talk about sort of bridging the gap between digital and physical, or electrons or photons to atoms, right? But devil's advocate.
Okay.
So here's me playing devil's advocate. Photographers watching this may be saying, oh, yeah, that's great, but you know what? I have Lightroom. I have this Mac that I spent all this money on. I have this Epson printer and a stack of printer paper, and I can go to Michael's and get it framed.
There you go.
You know, and what about those people?
Those people are fine. They don't need me.
You're not my customer.
You know what? But the reason that I created this in the first place was that was me. Mm-hmm. That was me, and...
Michael's pricing is ridiculous. Sorry, Michael's, but no.
But there's all kinds of frame places in America. You know, you can go to different, you know, custom frame places.
Yeah.
And so I had these printers in my home, and I would take pictures, and I quit my job last summer to be a full-time photographer.
Congratulations.
That's how this started.
Yeah.
I'd been at Adobe, and I just decided, you know what, I'm old. Mm-hmm. I think I have waited long enough. Yes. This has been a hobby my whole life, but I think it's time that I'm going to take it up a notch.
Yeah, yeah.
And so I started printing my pictures. I started selling my pictures. But when you do that, you need to mat them and frequently frame them. And mm-hmm. every time I'd get it matted and framed, it was expensive. It was across town. It was 2 weeks. It was like it was a major hassle.
Yeah.
And then the question was, why is it so hard? Because it's just not that complicated.
Yeah.
Archival printing and framing is like all you do as a fine artist, but it's not what consumers do at all.
Sure.
Yep. And so I guess I started this just trying to shortcut. I mean, yes, you can print yourself. You can go across town. You can handle all the parts of this.
Mm-hmm.
But my lesson from Petroglyph and the ceramic business, and even from Netflix, which mm-hmm. was where I was, you know, before Adobe,
mm-hmm.
it's like, simplification is critical.
Yeah.
And it's not, people think they want options, but the truth is they want to not have a lot of decision making, and they want it affordable and they want it easy.
Yeah.
And that's what I was trying to bring to what is arguably, it's not complicated, but there's a ton of decisions to be made about framing.
Yeah.
And I wanted to get rid of all those decisions. We only have three sizes, two colors, it's a flat rate. And people just, you know what you're going to pay for, and you get museum quality, concierge service, and you don't, we're not nickel and diming anyone. We don't care how big your print is. We're not measuring your print. We're not measuring all this stuff and charging you by the square inch.
That's great.
And it just seemed important to me, if you're going to bring this to the consumer market and tap them into the professional pipeline, we need to simplify it also.
Love it.
So that's what we're doing. So yes, you can go to Michael's and other frame places,
yep.
but you won't have this kind of experience. And I don't think that they care about photography the same way.
Right. No, they don't.
And
they
I don't. Really wanted a business that was not about, it's not a frame business. Mm-hmm. It's not even a printing service.
Yeah.
It is a photographer's.
I was going to say, it's about photography.
It's about photography.
It's about photography.
And we care about photography. It's one, yeah. it's why we're here, you know? And it's why we have great computers with great monitors and expert printers and this museum of like really inspirational stuff to look at.
I love it. I love it. So to wrap us up.
Yes.
What's next?
What
it's 2018. We're like a couple
2018?
Days in.
I'm still writing 2017 on my checks.
I'm still writing 2016. it's 2018 already.
Yeah.
What are your plans for this year? What do you want to do?
Well, you know, people have asked if we're going to open more of these.
Yeah.
And it's definitely something I would think about.
Mm-hmm.
But the truth is, my model is a little bit more like L.L. Bean. Mm-hmm. You know,
mm-hmm.
where, I mean, I don't know if you ever did this, but I would make a pilgrimage to Freeport, Maine
yeah.
in the dead of winter just to go to that epicenter of stuff. And you yeah. could buy the things in the catalog,
sure.
but it was cool to go there,
yeah.
right?
Yeah.
So this is
be
like
surrounded by that
yeah,
stuff.
The yeah. ethos. So this is like a place I want people to make pilgrimages to experience Neomodern directly, the gallery and to work with concierges. But 2018 is our year to package that in a way that we can deliver it online to people.
Awesome. So you can scale.
And we can scale, and mm-hmm. we don't have to build more stores. What happens is people can upload their pictures the way our customers do, sign up for an appointment the way many of our customers do,
mm-hmm.
and then we connect with you and share our screen, and you can interact with the printmaster live
mm-hmm.
and talk with us while we're working on your picture, and then we print it and frame it and ship it.
Yeah.
And it doesn't really add, it doesn't add anything to the cost. It's the same as being in the gallery.
Yeah.
And so the vision is to like to export the experience of Neomodern and our passion about photography on the internet without opening more stores.
Sure. That's and what's the aversion to opening more physical stores?
Well, you know, again, it's like I want something that's super special.
Yeah, you want to have like the nucleus, the sun.
Yeah. I don't know that every physical space we get will be as beautiful as this one.
I know. This is ridiculous.
It's a really cool spot.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
Will we open? I could imagine we could do this in New York and in LA perhaps. And, mm-hmm. and the model, the early Apple model was pretty cool that mm-hmm. they would have these sort of flagships.
Yeah.
But I'm not wed to that. I would like to expand online.
Refine this one, go online, and then see what happens.
Yeah. And I think that we could also be a voice for sort of the creative side of photography and mm-hmm. not get stuck in the home decor side of it. It's like,
yeah.
we want people, they're taking pictures, let's help them. Let's be the new place for hobbyist photographers. And I think that there'll be a lot more people who are into photography now that they have these cool cameras.
Absolutely, absolutely.
So that's what I'm thinking.
So if people want to learn more about Neomodern.
Well, they can physically come by. If you're in San Francisco, we're on Union Street at Laguna. And it's this great, it's in the Clock Tower building and it's across from Starbucks.
Campus. And
just walk on in.
Mm-hmm.
If you're not in San Francisco, I would go to neomodern.com
mm-hmm.
and you can get information there. And there's an online part of the website. And we're refining this all the time.
Sure.
But that's where you would upload your pictures and make an appointment. And then we'll kind of handle it from that.
Nice. So just to wrap it up. So if I come in the store, it's a concierge kind of experience where I come in, I sit down, mm-hmm. I work with a printmaster,
Yeah.
go out, have a coffee, come back, and I got my print. I'm ready to go.
You got your frame. You're done.
Got my frame print.
Yeah, you're
I'm
done.
Ready to go.
Yeah.
If I upload online, I can make an appointment. I give you guys the image, make an appointment, come in. Hey, Frederick, we got your image.
And
let's
in
go
fact, if you don't even want to interact with us, I mean, mm-hmm. you could trust our printmasters to make a great print out of this. I would argue that it doesn't take much interaction with you. If you don't want to talk to us, you don't have to talk to us.
Yeah.
But we are available.
Some notes online, right? Yeah.
But we're available. And a lot of people have questions. They don't understand how big it can be, the megapixels. They don't know what we could do with it.
Mm-hmm.
It's not like just applying an Instagram filter. Like an artist works on your picture.
Sure.
It makes it cool.
Yeah.
So we can do that online. We'll send you a link. And then we ship it out the next day.
When you say you do it online, that means you're going to do it collaboratively with the client.
Correct.
Online.
We
not
share,
like you guys take it and make the decisions.
Yes.
You're going to do a Skype session or Zoom or something.
Yeah, yeah, we're sharing our screen. You're mm-hmm. looking at our screen while we're modifying your picture, okay. and you're telling us like, oh, can you fix that? That's mm-hmm. weird.
Can you take that person out?
Yeah, really. Yeah, yeah, yeah. And we do some basic Photoshop Lightroom stuff if mm-hmm. you want to like remove little things. If it's actually work, if people want like retouching, we will right. do that, but it's a different charge. Right.
Can you take all the cars off the Golden Gate Bridge for me?
Like that. Like that.
You're like, probably not.
We've had people like, they're on a golf course with a million people, and they want everyone else off the golf course. Like, we've seen that one.
Yeah. By the golf course.
Anyway, that's awesome. Neomodern.
Awesome.
Dude, Michael Rubin, great to see you.
Thank you so much for doing this.
Thanks for coming.
Congratulations on your space, man. This is great.
It's nice. I'm glad you like
you
it.
You always have amazing, creative, good ideas. And the most important piece of that is you execute on them very
Thank
well.
You. So, thank you. Well, I hope other people will try this out and let us know how it goes.
All right. Well, guys, that's it. This is This Week in Photo. We'll see you in the next interview.
This is TWiP.